If you love mobile payments and you think it's the greatest thing since sliced bread, or if you hate mobile payments and you just want it to go away so you can use your phone for things like making a call, then stay tuned. We'll dive right into where mobile payments will be in the next 5 years, how it originated, and what companies are committed to making sure that you use it the next time you visit their store. Next on this edition of The Savvy Report. Hi everyone, I'm Ernie Martin, founder and managing director of Receivable Savvy, and welcome to this edition of The Savvy Report. According to Allied Market Research, a research and advisory company that provides business insights, mobile payments, or the method of paying for goods and services through the transfer of money through mobile and smartphones, is set to see growth at a compound annual rate of 34%. Between now and 2023. Mobile payments is also expected to achieve a market size of $4.6 trillion by that time. That's a lot of zeros and ones. The mobile payment market can be categorized by mode of transaction, type of mobile payment, application, and region. The segmented regions of the mobile payment market include North America, Europe, Asia Pacific, Latin America, Middle East, and Africa. The Asia-Pacific market represented the largest mobile payment market share in 2016 due to the high mobile penetration platform for e-commerce transactions, even more so than North America, and we thought our kids were glued to their phones. A key discovery regarding the drivers for the increase in mobile payment use is the growing number of smartphones, as well as faster network capability. For example, in Canada, 56% of citizens had smartphones in 2014. In 2016, that number had grown to 68%. In the UK, adoption of 4G network speed saw an increase over the past year from 26 to 55%. In another study conducted by Orima Consulting Group, although mobile payments are seeing a significant increase, those using smartphones for payments are not necessarily encouraging others, say family and friends, to do the same. In fact, over the last year, more smartphone users were indicating that they would not recommend the service to others, rising from 31% to 42%. Perhaps the key to that piece of data is where more mobile payment users are not recommending the service to others lies in the fact that 87% of users are not very active, meaning they're likely only using their mobile devices once or twice to make a payment for the novelty of it. But it's not yet part of their everyday lives. But that should begin to change over the next few years as mobile payments begin to permeate more areas of commerce. In all, the mobile payment market is maturing fast, but that does not mean that growth has plateaued, as evidenced by the data from Allied Market Research. But good old-fashioned cash, checks, and credit cards still represent a significant amount of transactions. Starbucks Corporation has announced that it's increasing its efforts to grow sales through its digital initiative that allows for ordering and payment via mobile devices. During the second quarter of its fiscal year, Starbucks has seen significant increase in mobile transactions, showing that these transactions account for roughly 12% of all transactions in the U.S. for the quarter. This is having a positive effect on sales in the U.S., where same-store sales have increased 2% during the recent quarter. That's better than the 1.8% analysts expected. But the challenge for Starbucks was that traffic in the U.S. stores was flat. Starbucks hopes to increase sales further by marrying its mobile app to its loyalty program. During its most recent quarter, Starbucks has added 1.6 million members to its loyalty program in the U.S. alone, an increase in 12% year over year. Its loyalty program accounted for 39% of sales in the U.S. for company-owned stores. So you can see Starbucks is heavily invested in its mobile payment initiative tied to its loyalty program. But Starbucks needs to do this. Competition from the likes of McDonald's, who has its own line of gourmet coffees and plans to roll out mobile ordering in all U.S. locations, has positioned itself as a worthy alternative to Starbucks. Conducting business via mobile devices is here to stay among quick service restaurants like Starbucks and McDonald's. And you can expect more companies to jump on that bandwagon very soon. Mobile payment is big business. With mobile devices and smartphones becoming more common every single day, it makes sense that using these devices to make payments is the next logical step, right? Well, perhaps, but mobile payments sort of started out by accident. According to a recent article in The Economist titled "How Money is Spreading," it seems mobile payment had its origins in Kenya, where Safaricom, the country's largest mobile company, initiated a pilot in 2005 after researchers discovered that Kenyans were transferring mobile airtime to each other, similar to how money might be transferred. The light bulb went on, and plans to handle microcredit repayments was started. What is now known as M-Pesa is the most popular way of moving money in and around Kenya, where the phone is used as a virtual wallet, where the SIM card and phone account are used sort of as a bank account. Similarly, Alipay, the smartphone-based payment system now very common in China, was started as a service for one of Alibaba's business sectors, where small businesses could sell direct to Chinese consumers. In the U.S., mobile pay solutions such as Apple Pay and Android Pay have a lot of catching up to do. You likely saw commercials for Apple Pay where someone doesn't use Apple Pay and slows the checkout line to a crawl while everybody sort of looks at them cross-eyed. Well, it's a great commercial, but we're not there yet. Apple Pay, according to Apple itself, is only in about 50% of available retail locations. And many of those retail locations don't have actual working devices yet. That's a far cry from Europe and Asia, where mobile payments are far and away more accepted than in the US. But in the next 5, 10, or 15 years, I think the U.S. will begin phasing out in earnest existing payment options such as paper checks, credit cards, and yes, actual paper money. Well, that's it for this week's edition of the Savvy Report. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.